Welcome to the Learning Mentor. So in this video we are going to learning about how to create an airfoil with tubercles. So basically tubercles are bumps which are created on an airfoil or a wing, you can say, which basically increases the aerodynamic performance of an airfoil. So our task is to create an airfoil NACA 23012 with a chord of 100 millimeters span and 100 millimeters chord, and we have to create it with tubercles. If you want to watch the video without tubercles, I have left the link in the description. So basically we have to create with an amplitude equal to 7% of the chord length. So basically our chord is 100 millimeters, and if we multiply 7% with it, it is equal to 7 millimeters. We have to create an tubercle with 7 millimeters amplitude, and we have to create it with an wavelength of 25 millimeters. So first of all we have to create a cross section of airfoil. So I am coming to my web browser. I have searched for NACA 23012 in my Google browser, and the first link is appearing of airfoiltools.com. I am going to be clicking on it. So I have gotten the airfoil tools website where I can choose this select format dat file so that I can create an XYZ plane or an XYZ curve on my SOLIDWORKS file. I have clicked on it. So there is a select data available over here, which is an XY data for the curve. I am going to copy all of it and create an Excel file for myself. Now I am going to paste data over here. As you can see that the data is currently in only one column, and it is the both values of the data are in one cell. Now we want to separate this data. So we will select this whole column by clicking on the A column, and then we go to data and then we select text to columns. The easiest way to do is with fixed width and next. So it automatically detects, make sure that your old data is over here, then next, finish. So we have created ourselves two columns, we have separated the data. Now remember that this is X and Y points. When we use the curve with XYZ, we also need the Z coordinate. So currently our Z coordinate is 0, so I am going to fill it with 0 all along. So I have created the coordinates for our airfoil. Now I am going to save it. I have created already a folder on my desktop with this. I am going to name it NACA airfoil 2. Okay, so I am going to remember also the model. I am going to save it with the model name 23012. Okay, so this is NACA 23012. I am going to change the type of this file. I am going to give this file a tab deleted file. Now it is NACA 23102. Already there is also another file saved of NACA airfoil over here. I am going to save it. Now make sure you close this Excel window, otherwise the SOLIDWORKS won't be able to use the file. I have closed the window. I have already opened a SOLIDWORKS part file. Now I am going to select my front plane, and I am going to features, then I am going to curve, then curves through XYZ points. You can also go to insert and then curve and curve through XYZ point, all depending on your choice. I am going to browse the file which I have created, or it is on my desktop. I am going to change the file type from here. I am going to select 23012 which I have created the file. Open. So this data has been imported to SOLIDWORKS curve. If I place OK, our curve has been placed. You cannot see because the then we can use zoom to fit option to see our airfoil. If I select the front plane and make it normal too, you can see our airfoil cross section clearly. I am going to select this curve, this front plane. Now I am going to sketch. You can see this curve is placed via origin. We don't want it to be on the origin. I am going to select this curve. I am going to convert entities. I am going to hide this curve now from here. Hide this curve. Now this curve is fixed to this origin. I want to remove it from the origin, so I am going to use the copy command by Control C, or you can use the move entities command as well, or you can use copy entities command from here as well. I am going to select the start point from here. I am going to move it a bit. I am going to delete this older curve. Okay. I am going to move this curve someplace over here. I am going to pan from here using Control and my middle mouse button. As you can see, this is an open end. We are going to close it via a tangent arc. I am going to create a tangent arc from these two points. As you can see, the point is coming like this. We don't need this point to be like this. I can change this. I am selecting again tangent arc from this to this point. I have completed my cross section. Now as you can see, the contour of this cross section means our airfoil sketch is complete. Now we have to first of all assign it an chord length. For that I am going to use center line. I am going to center this. Okay. So our chord line is ready. I am also going to create a vertical line. So that I can place the center over here. So I am going to create a random center over here, which shall be perpendicular line. Okay. I am going to make this intersection and this origin coincident. I am going to use intersection. Okay, so our airfoil is aligned to our origin, which will make it easier for us in the ANSYS simulation. Okay. Now we have the cross section of the airfoil is made. Now if we look, we have a chord of 100 millimeters. So I am going to create a smart dimension of 100 millimeters. Okay, so our 100 millimeters of cross section is done. Our airfoil cross section has been made. Now as I am going to exit sketch, as you can see, my airfoil cross section is looking very good. Now we have to create tubercles. Now before that, we have to do some calculations for the tubercles. Now remember these parameters which we have made. The chord is of 100 millimeters, span is of 100 millimeters, and amplitude is of 7 millimeter, and the wavelength we have is of 25 millimeter. Now how much planes we have to create, it will be decided by number of planes is equals to span upon wavelength upon 2. Now wavelength upon 2, why it is over here? So that we can create some bumps of equal sizes. So wavelength upon 2, which will be 12.5, and the span, which is 100, we have to create total of 8 planes with a distance of 12.5, which is this factor. Now we also need to know what scale, at what scale we should minimize it. So the scale factor, to find the scale factor, we use this formula, 1 minus amplitude upon chord length, which is only the ratio of amplitude over chord length, which is 0.07, and the factor we find is 0.93, which means the lower plane, the lower profile will be of scale 0.93. Now we are going to create the plane. First of all, I am going to features, then references, then plane. Now to get the first reference, I am going to select wait a second, so I can modify some things. Okay, now it's ready. I'm going to select front plane first of all, then I'm going to reference plane. As you can see, it is already selected the front plane. Now we want at a distance of 12.5 millimeters. Okay, now I think this is clear. Okay, now we have created a plane at a certain distance. Now I am going to select this plane, sketch. I am going to go normal to by selecting this plane and normal to. Okay, so the previous sketch we are going to select it. We are also going to have to select this smaller one. I am going to convert entities. Now we are going to scale this. So now to scale it, I am going to go for scale entities. Entities to scale. I am going to select these objects. Okay, scale about. We are going to scale about this end point which we have selected. We have to be scaling about this point. Okay, so we have selected this point, and the factor which we have to give is 0.93. So 0.93 is our factor. Okay, and so to check this, I am going to create a line from this point over here, and I am going to check this dimension, which will be equal to 7 millimeters. I am going to delete this line. Okay, we have got only one sketch now available over here. If there are more than one sketches, we will be deleting it. Delete this sketch. Okay, curve is okay, perfect. Now we are going to repeat it for how many planes? For 8 planes. We have created one plane. Now we have to create more 7 more planes in order to achieve the length. So I am going to exit the sketch. I am going to create sketch reference geometry plane. First reference will be this plane. and OK. I'm going to again create another plane. Remember, we have to create 7 more planes, 3 and more 5 planes we have to need. Plane, OK. Plane, OK. Plane, OK. Plane, OK. How many planes we have right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we need one more plane. Plane. Okay. So how many planes we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 planes. Which means 12.5 from here. 12.5 from here, which is 25. 25 and 25, 50, 50 and 25, 75, 75 and 25, which is equal to 100 millimeter. Now I am going to just do something very simple. I am going to select this plane, sketch. I am going to copy this sketch over here by convert entities, selecting this, also this end cap over here. And simply convert entities. I'm going to select this, exit sketch, plane 3 sketch. I'm going to now copy this. So select this, convert entities, exit sketch, select this sketch. I'm going to copy with this one. So select this, also this one, convert entities, okay, more 5 planes over here, exit this sketch, this one, sketch, then plane select, select this, this, convert entities, exit. Select the plane, sketch, select copying sketch, convert entities, exit sketch, selecting this sketch, sketch, then convert entities. Exit sketch, selecting this sketch, selecting this, convert entities. Our planes and our sketches are ready. Now we are going to use the loft base command, lofted boss base command, to create our typical airfoil, the airfoil with waves, you can say that. So I'm going to select lofted boss base. Now we have to select the sketches. For simplicity, I'm going to go over here and select all the sketches available. Okay, so I'm going to also hide the planes. Now as you can see that our airfoil with tropicals is ready. If you want to verify the span of this airfoil, you can simply go to top plane, normal, sketch, line,
and if I dimension it, make sure the line is on the end of this, because currently mine isn't. I'm going to delete it. I'm going to create another line over here just in order to check the code. Okay, this is okay. Now I'm going to smart dimension it to allow me to know what length our, see, this is 100 mm, length is 100 mm. You can also see over here length is 100 mm. I'm going to delete this and I'm going to isometric view. So our airfoil with tropicals has been created. I hope you like our video, so subscribe to my channel. Also connect with me on LinkedIn. If you want to create a smooth airfoil, you can watch our previous video as well. Subscribe to my channel as well, so that I can have motivation to create more videos like these. And Allah Hafiz.